In our last video, we wired the first non-computing instruction, data instruction, to bring the initial data into the registers. In this video, we will start programming and figure out what other instructions we might need. If you like our work, please support us by sharing, subscribing, adding likes and comments. Your support will motivate us keep making great videos. Now we will start programming with the instructions we have to produce the Fibonacci sequence. We need to add 0 and 1 first, so we need to bring them into these two registers using data instructions. The instruction takes 2 bytes, the instruction itself and the data. They are in electrical voltages. Let's put them here so that's easier to see. Voltages are hard to read, so programmers write programs using symbols they can understand. They will be translated into voltages later. So we use data R00 to move a 0 to here. Let's color the data as purple 0 so that it's clear to us what it is. When you're coding, it's better to keep these little notes reminding yourself what you're doing. Another data instruction to move 1 into R1. Then we need the memory locations to store the results. Since we will store them one after another, hence all we need is the starting location and the constant increment. Replace the starting location into R2 using data instruction. But which location should we store the results from? This is a very simple CPU model. It doesn't have the fancy mechanism to prevent overwriting the program space. Because the instructions will also be stored in memory, so you have to be careful not to overwrite them. Hence, you need to have some basic ideas about how many bytes the instructions might take. In our case, I don't think we will have more than 30 bytes, so I'm going to store the result from location 32. Each row has 16 units, so 32 would be the first one of the third row. Let's mark it here. If later on our program takes more space, we can adjust this number. Another data instruction to bring over the constant increment. Once these parameters are here, we can do the computing part. First, we need to add the 2 initial inputs to get the blue one. We use add instruction. Be careful about the sequence, because based on the wiring, the second input register will be overwritten with the result. And for the next round, we still need to keep this green one. So we use add R1 R0 so that after execution, 0 gets overwritten with the result. Then we need a store instruction to store the content of R0 according to the address in R2. We don't know the machine code yet, but we will find out when we do the wiring. So this store instruction will bring the first result over. Once that's done, we can compute the second round. Add these 2 again. Result will be in R0. Now there's an issue. We need to keep adding the 2 results together. But now the first result, the blue one, is gone. The good news is, we have a copy of it in the memory. And the current address in R2 is pointing to it. So we need a load instruction, loading this blue one back. We will talk about the wiring shortly, but what it does is to load some data from memory into R1, and the location of the data is in R2. So you can see the structure of the load and store instructions are the same. The target register is in the back, the memory location in the middle. Now we can store the red result. First, we need to calculate the next address by adding these 2. So we need add instruction. You want R2 to be overwritten with a new address, because you want to keep increasing it to get the next one. Once increased, it's pointing to the next unit. Then we can store the content of this R0 according to the new address in R2. Now let's see how do wires store and load instructions. Store instruction needs to move content of R0 into RAM, according to the memory location in R2. These four register bits are used to select two registers. One of them has the memory address, one of them has the data. So we name them as RARB to distinguish. RA has the address, RB has the data. Address is in R2, so we need a high-low for the RA. Data is in R0, so low-low for RB. These four register bits will get R0 and R2 ready to output. They are waiting for the right time. That's coming from the operation code through the instruction decoder. Say we use the second wire to power it. Then for the 4-bit operation code, we need a low computing bit, then a low low high will turn on the second wire. In terms of wiring, we only need two steps. First step to move the memory address, then move the data. So we need two conditional step wires. They will turn on as step 4 and 5 when it's store instruction. First we move the address from here to here. So we need to turn on RA and memory address register. This control line is for RA, but because it's already connected to computing instruction, we need to use OR gate here. So connect the step 4 wire to RA, then connect to memory address register. So at step 4, when power is on, the address gets here, the cell is selected, ready for input. Second step, we move the result from RB to RAM. So we turn on RB and RAM. This control line is for RB. Using OR gate for RB, connect RB and RAM to step 5. So step 5, result will be moved from R0 into RAM location 32. Store instruction is done. Next, load instruction. Store instruction is to send data from a register to RAM. Load instruction is doing the opposite, send data from RAM to a register. Their instruction structures are the same, with a memory location in RA and a target register in RB. In our case, the memory location is in R2, so high-low for RA. Target register is R1, so low-high for RB. Say we're using the first wire to power it. So for the operation code, 4 lows will turn on the first wire. Similar to store instruction, we only need two steps. First to move the memory address, then move the data. So two conditional step wires are needed. Step 4, connect RA and memory address register. Step 5, connect RAM and RB. But this time, RAM is the sender, RB is the receiver. So connect these pair. When power is on, after step 5, the first result will be loaded into R1. We're done with the wiring. Now we can put the missing machine codes here for load and store instructions. In the next video, we will talk about how to do computing for the next rounds. It will be very interesting, as we will finally get into looping, the programming piece that I always found intriguing and mysterious.